Hello! Every week I'll be taking a look at some of the biggest bands and performers in my A to Z of pop music. So it's time to pop a coin in my slot and crank up the Jukasse jukebox. So let's start at the very beginning with A. And A is all about the groups. First up we've got ABBA. Now ABBA were one of the most commercially successful pop acts ever and of course won the Eurovision Song Contest held in Brighton back in 1974 with Waterloo. In 2005, at the 50th anniversary celebration of the Eurovision Song Contest, Waterloo was chosen as the best song in the competition's history. And with over 500 million record sales, they really were a force to be reckoned with, until they disbanded in 1982. The group's split saw the decline in their popularity, however, their music lived on and was used in the box office hits such as Muriel's Wedding and Priscilla Queen of the Desert, and of course their music helped shape the story arc for the 1999 stage musical Mamma Mia, which in 2005 saw all four members of the band reunite in Stockholm for the very first time since 1986. Despite a decline in their popularity after the split, the Super Troopers are known for being dance floor fillers at parties. But behind the scenes, they also experienced their own personal heartache. Agnetha and Bjorn and Frida and Benny were married, but sadly separated during the group's career. Their biggest selling hit was Fernando, selling 10 million copies. However, for all you girls and gays, it's gotta be Dancing Queen. You're in the mood for a dance. So next we have Atomic Kitten, and Atomic Kitten were formed in Liverpool back in 1998 with original band members Kerry Katona, Liz McLarnon and Heidi Range, who went on to find success as one of the Sugar Babes. She was replaced early on by the Ginger Whinger, I'm saying nothing else, Natasha Hamilton. The group's debut album Right Now was released in October 2000 and peaked at number 39 in the UK charts. After a line of four top 10 singles, Kerry went out on a high and quit the band, announcing she was pregnant to former Westlife crooner Brian McFadden. She was instantly replaced by former Eurovision band member Jenny Frost, and Hole Again became their most successful single ever and became the 13th best-selling single of the noughties. The group replaced all of Kerry's vocals on the re-released album, which hit number one in the UK and went double platinum. The new lineup released two further albums in 2002 and 2004. Then they announced their split with the Greatest Hits album and tour, featuring most of their biggest hits, Ladies Night, Eternal Flame, and The Tide Is High. You might remember that the group reunited to appear in the ITV2 series, The Big Reunion. And with Jenny Frost unable to take part because of a pregnancy, the door was open for Kerry to return, wearing a crown as I'm a Celeb winner and prawn ring princess. £1. The group were Hole Again. So now we have Aqua. Aqua have sold a staggering 33 million records and are the most successful Danish band ever. Originally called Joyspeed, the band cancelled their very first record contract after their debut single failed to set the charts alight. And to be honest, I'm not surprised. It was called Itsy Bitsy Spider. The Eurodance group sparked major controversy with the double entendres in their single Barbie Girl, as well as a knuckle rap with the Barbie doll makers Mattel, who filed a lawsuit against the group claiming the song damaged the image of Barbie. The lawsuit was finally dismissed by a judge in 2002, who ruled, and I quote, "The parties are advised to chill." Aqua were predicted to be a one-hit wonder, but actually went on to have a string of hits including Dr. Jones, Cartoon Heroes, and their gorgeous ballad Turn Back Time, which made the lead single to the blockbuster movie Sliding Doors. Remember that one? So come on, Barbie, let's go party.
Girl,
Join me next time for the next exciting letter in our A to Z musical alphabet as I invite you to go pop with me.